I mean, I wouldn't say. I mean, I knew we was going to have to face them either way. Being the first game is always, it's definitely the stepping stone for and the set off for your season. So you always want to get that first game under your belt and lead and your build up your confidence for the rest of the season. So it's definitely a big game and. I'm looking forward to I definitely know I played against I played with Marcus Forson, the D tackle. I was talking to Danny earlier. He was in the All American bowl with me in 2008 and I remember just how good he was then and I know he's gotten better playing in Miami, and when I asked Danny, he was like, yeah, he's definitely one of the guys that was causing some havoc.
Sorry, can you rewind for a second, even from what Tori and I found out? So what is
Joe Flacco
doing that you're not?
Well, it's not really like that. It's just, you know, it's just, I ask him, like, yo, what are you guys doing? What route do you guys take?
Yeah, yeah.
But, I mean, we had the luxury last year of, you know, playing in a pro style offense. And Tori's like, you know, for him, personally, for him, it's like, you know, I've run every route that I've run out of the region, so.
We're always just trying to make each other better.
I mean, I've seen his playbook a little bit.
Danny's a quarterback. He makes reads.
That's not my primary concern. It's just, you know, like really when you throw him with Tori after we have to throw
him. Every day we just battle, going against each other.
I mean, you're for the ACC Rookie of the Year last year, and all of a sudden you're like the veteran. What's that transition been like for you?
One play, it could be a bat down, and the next play, it could be a 30-yard
touchdown. That's kind of kept me. Kept the blinders on and kept away from all like, the expectations and stuff because you can't really control what other teams are doing at quarterback. But I mean, it just so happened that it timed up that a lot of quarterbacks left. So I'm fine with that. I'm comfortable with it. And, you know, it's just going to come down to playing on Saturdays. The media stuff's awesome, but I mean, I got to have last year's over.
Game, when the game
do you feel, though, like you have any edge because you do have a year of experience, whereas over half the league has. It's like you were last year.
Yeah. It's crazy. I think so, though. I think experience is, you know, you can't substitute that. So I feel way more comfortable playing this year than last year. I watched a ton of film last year, but until I actually got out there and played.
Eric is very, very smart and talented.
You just can't substitute. So.
He's definitely a good tackle.
I think we do have an edge. I think if you can get consistent quarterback play, you got a good chance to win.
I mean, safety right behind me. So,
we'll see.
He's definitely one of the guys that he's not real. He's soft spoken. He doesn't really yell. He doesn't do all those type of things. And that's just not like I am. So, we definitely connected a lot.
We might run the exact same play we ran last year, but it's awesome. We know each other. Memorizing what you call stuff. But from offensive standpoint, what fans are going to see is not for
me. I feel like if you definitely make some plays, you can definitely call lengthy. He can definitely
it's just kind of his personality and both his philosophy on football kind of being set down.
We do. I think we have two of the big safeties again this year.
It's not night and day.
That's been the trend
for
the last couple of years, so that's definitely good in the run for us.
Sitting out the running, it hasn't changed, so in that respect, the culture has changed. It's just really his personality getting set up.
Could you say the mix of plays being roughly the same and everything?
Yeah, it's pretty similar. Obviously, you know, any coordinator you get to be a little bit different. But you know, internally, it's a lot different.
From Matt versus
Gonzaga. From a fan's perspective.
And they were up.
They reinvented the lead.
6-0.
Danny, I wanted to ask you about being a young guy playing in the ACC.
Finally, we won 7-0, but the whole game, it was like a battle. And then I finally used to run the ball with the ball, and I scored.
You can't force. I mean,
but before that,
from my first
they had went
to my
up and scored a touchdown,
like
but it was called back.
Not necessarily with our offense.
So every time he says we should have won that game, I was like, if you wouldn't have held, y'all would have went up 14. And you might have won. I don't think you would have, but you held the jersey, man. You can't be holding that.
How long did it take for you to
kind
of feel that jump in your game?
I think for me, things kind of clicked.
You mentioned your defensive coordinator at the Nathan and the one who told you, hey, you could take
it. Really,
what's his
name?
Dino Campbell.
You could dictate what the defense is going to do.
How much has life changed on a day-to-day basis?
What kind of advice? There's a lot of young quarterbacks coming.
What kind of disciplinarian
is he? What kind of advice
for things? Stricter now, less strict, or what are things like on day-to-day?
I think, you know,
day-to-day is the same, other than, I mean,
staying confident in your abilities.
Both of the coaches have things that we have to do, per se.
I think, you know,
freezing. Just taking away your coaches telling you, you made all in the morning, mostly. Now we have meetings in the morning. Freezing, we didn't have meetings in the morning, pretty much.
Everything else
when we got to football. But now, like,
you started it like in the middle of the season when you became a starter. Do you think it would have been easier if you had been the starter from game one?
We're meeting at 7 in the morning.
Who knows?
We're all out of attention.
Like to say so, maybe, but I
what's the news?
I wouldn't trade last year.
Ready on with our day, so now we're definitely up
at the time,
for breakfast and things like that. So, we're just moving around pretty good.
It is what it is. But
and is it tough when you guys say somebody misses a class?
Is Vanderbilt your second favorite college
football team? Does he do?
Only have one team. Yeah, I mean, I wish Coach Franklin all the best. I know he's going to do a good job there.
As the captains, we took it upon
ourselves. I'll think. Figure out my fan teams after I leave.
Will you be interested to see how he does there, though?
I'll keep tabs on it. I mean,
we know
obviously, he's a big reason why I came to Maryland in the first place.
That's definitely big cut down now that we say coach.
I know he's going to do a great job.
So when he gets the report from
he seems to have developed a really good relationship with guys. Like some guys are really sort of closely tied to him and like him a lot.
We can't allow that to happen.
I mean,
that's not
his
job.
Like I said, he's a big reason why I came to Maryland in the first place. And, you know, I owe a lot of my success last year to him because he really showed me the way as far as how to watch film, how to prepare practice, you know, how to be a leader. He really took my game to the next level. And I owe a lot of that to him, and I've learned a lot of new things from Coach Grogan. But I've really kept a solid foundation that Coach Franklin taught me. So, and that he's a really genuine guy, so in that respect, he's easy to
certain things can work in the SEC that you guys did.
I think it can. I mean, it's going to start, you know, playing consistent football and getting good players in there, which I'm sure they have now. I mean, he runs a pro-style offense, so I mean, that's worked.
I know. I like the conference. He likes to go defense and like what's going on, so that.